machine, and I kill raptors with my horny horn. Bow-bow-bow. What is up, the world? Boy, I hope that Quetzal doesn't poop. It's your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here. Maybe I will. Nope. Hanging out today, doing stuff and things, playing some Ark Survival of all peeps. Kind of a rainy day, but it's still a good day. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. And the voting is in. And you guys have voted to keep Zul'jin's color, which is great, I guess. I'm a little surprised, but it's a thing that happened, and I said that we would keep it. So we're definitely going to. And I hope that you guys had fun taking part in the straw poll and doing all that stuff. But one thing's for sure. I will not waste the amazing name from one of my favorite comedic troops from the state of Maine on this bird. So we're going to keep the paint job because you guys piped up. You voted. But we're going to change the name of him. So this guy is going to be known from now on as Pugly. Because he's pretty ugly. So anyway, I went around on the Quetzal today. Oh, I gotta stop a second and say thank you guys so much for all your support, likes, and everything that you do for me here on the channel. I really do appreciate it. If you guys like this video, I hope he doesn't poop on us. Please don't forget to smash the like button. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for more stuff and things. And all right, so we got Pugly, but what I did is I went around on him, and I went ahead and I did a bunch of leveling. So he's up to 61 now, and I've just been pumping weight only, right? And check it out. He's up to 1,600 weight already, man. Like, it's a huge amount. He's totally, like, ridiculously weighty. Can we fly out through here? Look at this. So he's not super duper fast or anything like that, but he has tons and tons of weight. And almost as much if we level him up a little bit more as basically bringing, like, tonnage and poundage over to the forge area here. So, oh, before we go, we actually do need to bring a couple birds with us. All right, yeah, I want to give you another update about the stuff and things that's going on. So we did a stream today. Survival of the Fittest game. We're going to be posting it to the channel, so keep your eyes peeled for that. It's going to be an exciting thing to behold for sure. So the metal situation, I think we have a little bit more than this, but not too much. Let's actually go ahead and get on the double here and take a look at the other thing here. So normally I would have done a bunch of getting of the metals, but like I said, today we did the streaming stuff. So over here, I think we have a little bit more. 2, 4, 6, almost 800, but that's it. We're really, really low. So yeah, doing this stuff out of metal, I hope you guys really appreciate it because it is a ton of off-camera work to get it done. But I think it's going to be cool and look good when it's over with. But all right, so for today, I think that we're going to start off the episode doing a little bit of that stuff because I didn't have time to get it done earlier. So what we're going to do is get on to Pugly, and we're going to go ahead and come over here. Let us whistle up poundage and tonnage. We'll bring them both with us and head up to the forge area here and do some stuff and things. Are you guys coming? So I'm trying to see also, I can't really tell if these guys are slower or faster. It looks like, I don't know if Pugly's holding his own in the speed department or not. It looks like he is. It looks like that maybe Pugly, in addition to having this amazing amount of weight, may actually also be a little bit faster than the RGs. So that's crazy. And on tonnage and poundage, I've only pumped weight on those guys too. So they just kind of have their base speed. And well, what's his base speed? So he does have 136.5% movement speed. So yeah, but coming over here, last night I did come up to the mobile forge, or not the mobile forge, the mountain forge. And I did get some stuff and things going on. How hard is it to see with our spyglass on this guy? Oh my gosh, it's super hard. That kind of stinks. And you can't, like, normally on the RGs, if I want to take a look around, I can fly up. And then their butts will get out of my way, but it looks like I can't do that on this guy. All right, so coming up over here, I did come up last night. I did get some metal on into the refining forges so that we would have some more. So I'm just going to land up here. Oh, we got a couple things that we can kill. You'll be able to see the amazingness, the power. You want some? So the Quetzal is absolutely like an overpowered fighting machine, man. Like, it does a knockback maneuver, and its AoE is like crazy. Like, the area that it does its attack in, guys, is just unbelievable. Is that a Dodick? What level are you, buddy? Let's come over here and land, guys. Let's take a look at this Dodicrous just to see. What level are you, big guy? Level 4? What? That's not even a mouse on a wheel. Oh, wait, our guns got switched around again. All right, there we go. Can we take this guy out just to call the herd? Oh, crap, we can't. No, don't bother, guys. Don't bother over there. All right, let's take a look. Let's pop inside of Hyun real quick and take a look at what we got going on. Are you guys going to attack him now? You're giving the attack music, but you're not actually doing it. All right, so we've got 300. Do I have it all full? All right, so we got it all filled up. So what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to offload this stuff all onto the birds. I'm going to take the Anki out and go ahead and fill these refining forges back up again. How much of this do we have? We got a good amount, but we're going to need a little bit more. So I'm going to basically recycle this whole area here, get it all ready to go again for, 3, 6, 9, 12, 1,500 more metal. And when I'm done, I will BRBs, peeps. And we're back. And I've been doing a bunch of stuff and things. It's actually been quite a while. I went back to the base. I built some more refining forges and brought them back over here because I was thinking the amount of metal we have up on the mountain, I'd be able to do a lot of like, I was like, I'll get tons and tons of metal. Actually, there's some right down there too. I don't want to bring the Anki that far away. But if it's just that, wow, we could go down there and get that stuff too. Anyway, I cleared the entire mountain. Oh, looks like there's a couple more nodes over there. I didn't even know until I got up on my flyer. So kind of, sort of, and I did notice also, there's some over here, man. There's like three of these really densely packed, or four right there, densely packed nodes, where we can't get them unless we were to have like a buddy. And we could do the trick where we get on the Quetzal and we pick up the Anki, but we need two people to do that. So, but anyway, the moral of the story is that we've got a lot more metal in here, but we didn't get quite as much as I thought. I figured we'd need a ton more refining forges to clear basically the most of the main mountain there, but we really only needed two extra. We filled up everything over here, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we got 6, and then we got some of this guy filled up. And actually, I think I have a little bit more right here. Like, so we probably could fill this guy up too. Let's see here. Oh yeah, 5. 1, 2, 3, bam, 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 I said. And then fill this guy up all the way to, like so. Nail the dice to keep it stuffed. All right, so then we'll pop this in here like this. And then we're going to need to get one more, like so. And then do we have, I'm going to put a little bit more stone on this, in this mortar and pestle like that. And grab this guy like so. Go ahead and squirt this in here like so. And we should have 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 2100 stone when we're done. So that's quite, 2100 stone, 2100 metal. That's quite a haul. That's not bad at all. So we're going to close this guy up. I got Stupid Pigeon right here. Let's see if we can get like, I don't know. I hope this works. Let's just do a, oh wait, I was going to do a J, but I don't think we can. You coming with me, Poundage? Let's do the correct whistle. There we go. All right, we got all three of them. It's a fleet. It's a flock. It's a formation. Is everybody coming? Wait, what are you doing back there, buddy? All right, here we go. Oh my God. So we got the whole group coming over here now. It looks like, I don't know. I'm trying to think if we could just bring the Quetzal in the future. Oh my gosh. There's tons of birds following me. But I think we'd always need to bring a little bit more, especially if we had like 2,100 metal. I don't think that Pugly could carry it all on his own. So we need a little bit more going on over here. So, all right, we're going to bring these guys back over into the house, into the home, into the base. And what I think we're going to do next is most likely, I think we might start working on the upper part of the base here. I want to kind of get that stuff sussed out. And again, we're going to do it in, did we lose somebody? Did we lose you? Where is he? Crap, oh, we did lose somebody. We're moving too quick. So I think what we're going to do is build it. And again, build it out of thatch and wooden pillars. And I think that's just the best bet to make sure that we're not wasting any metal doing this stuff and experimenting and stuff like that. But I gotta get the fleet home. Come on, buddy. Who is that? Tonnage, what are you doing back there, man? All right, we're gonna get the fleet home. And then we'll be our bees, peeps. And we're back. Just making up some gunpowder here to get some bullets. Refreshing my bullet supply. Let me go ahead and actually just put 50 in there. I made a few more tranquilizer darts. These things are expensive, peeps. We're living large here. So, yeah, it takes lots and lots of metal. Everything we're doing this season so far, as far as getting the base going and stuff, just takes like the hugest amount of metal ever. And I'm trying to think, like, as I was doing this, I was like, yeah, thinking about this, thinking about that. Is there a way that we can do this a little bit better? Is there a way that we can get metal faster? I think we've really kind of got a good system going on here. You just got to kind of get some a little bit in the morning and a little bit at night is how I've been doing this. So we're going to pull down this stuff right here. You know what would be sweet is if the demolish hot thing was in the same spot every time. It kind of moves around sometimes. It would be great if it was always up. It'd be a little bit more intuitive. So, all right, down over here, we did in the last couple episodes, a couple episodes ago, I think I showed you that, guys, this. We made a huge amount of stuff and things here. So we got tons and tons of wood pillars. Let me see. Let's get about 25 of those guys. And then can we carry 50 of those as well? Oh, we're burdened. You know what? Oh, I don't want to drop this stuff, but I just will. We'll just drop this. Hopefully. Oh, crapo. Can I get it to you? Oh, yeah, baby. Give it to me. And then we'll just grab all of these. Can you carry all of these, homie? Are you super strong? Oh, I think you can. And we got 50 of those. All right, sweet. So we got enough. Now we can come up here and start getting some building stuff and things done. So what I'm thinking about doing is taking this out, making this kind of this building kind of into like an L-type shape deal. So actually, we'll park you over here like so. So I'm thinking something like this. Now over here, let's go ahead and put some ceilings on our bar on one, and then let's grab some pillars as well. We'll grab just 25 of these guys, and we'll stick that on our hot bar in slot two. Wait, what? Really? Huh. I thought we were a baller. I thought we could carry more than that. All right, there we go. We got 25 at least. So now we can bring these, start bringing this area back here. And then, all right, so like this, like that, we can't. All right, like so and like so. Nope, and then like this and like this. And then these locations here, we're going to have to fit pillars. Now, this is going to be interesting because I don't think we're going to be able to get them to go like small, which kind of stinks. Like, oh, did I get it for a second? You know what I'm talking about? Like how you can place one basically like this so that it's underneath the ceiling. And I don't think that we're going to be able to do that here, but we still have to place them in order to make it happen. And we can't snap a foundation to a ceiling. So we can't really use foundations in this area in order to make it work. So I guess we'll just go like this. I don't want to have a pillar right in the middle, but I think we might have to. Oh, wait. No, we don't. Nailed the days to cave stopped, I think. Oh, we're not going to be able to do one there. So are we going to have a pillar in the middle? This is a conundrum. We might have to do some thinking. Oh, crap-o. Hmm. All right. Well, that actually means that we might go up a level and get some hot ramp action going. So wait a second, peeps. Now I got to rethink everything. We got to delete some of this stuff. And possibly we will be using some foundations here. Yeah, I'm just trying to wrap my head around it for a second. Trying to think about exactly how we're going to do this. Let me go ahead and make up some foundations, tear down some of this stuff. I think I got an idea. I think I thought about an idea. I'll be RB's, peeps. And we're back with some building 101 tips and tricks here. So I was trying to figure out how to get this to work. And I don't really even want the foundations here, but I put them up, and I'll tell you what about how we do this in a second. But so what I was thinking about doing, I was like, you know what I'll just do? I'll just pop a pillar down and I'll snap the foundation to it. So if you do that, what happens is the foundation snaps. So now it's snapping to this. You know, actually, we'll just destroy this so you can see. So if you put it here, you can see I can snap it, but it snaps at this level. Like, and it has to do with the position of this pillar. So that's why it's snapping right here like so. So what I decided to do is I just kind of went in to place it, and I wanted to place this foundation just as close as I could possibly place it to make it so that it was amazing and totally, you know, on. And it looks like it's really good. If you take a look at this gap right here, like it looks pretty amazing. I think it's the same gappiness. The gapitude is very similar across the entire range. So, yes, hashtag gapitude. And we're going to pop that out of there now. We should be able to go like this and like this and then just double check what's our gapitude like here. I mean, it looks pretty great. Like, I think it's pretty even throughout the entire process. It may get a little closer right at the edge, but it's really, really, it's pretty close to being on. So that's what I was thinking that we would do. And then we can rock some ceilings off of this. Or we could just do all foundations. And that's probably cheaper. If we take a look at metal pillars. So, oh, we can't craft those in here. But because basically, I don't know, The reason why I'm talking about the cheapness of it or the expense of the cost of building is that we've got a foundation, so we could use all foundations in this area, or we could use the pillars and the ceilings. But I think, I don't know, it's hard to say whether the foundations would be cheaper because we don't need to use the extra pillars, or if the pillars and ceilings are cheaper because we only need to use a pillar every once in a while. You know what I'm saying? So that sort of thing is what I'm thinking. So, yeah, but anywho, this is what we got here. Now we're going to get some ramps and place some ramps on the edge of this and move them across. I think that would be pretty good. Oh, yeah, you know what? The other thing that might be weird, too, is because we're going to be building on top of this stuff, when we build the foundations here, if we do transition over to ceilings, there'll be a little lip. There'll be a little like lip like this between the foundation and the ceiling. So that might be actually aesthetically kind of neat. Or it might be something that bugs us. It's kind of hard to say. It's kind of hard to decide. So let me go ahead. You know, I think we're going to have to use foundation just because we're not going to be able to place those pillars underneath. This is not going to be a way to do that. So that means we'll just start laying these guys out. And then I think I might go in like a straight line. Oh, I'm going to have to build a bunch more. And kind of count out the straight line of how many it would be. Because I think once we get over to this area here, we're going to start to make another. It's going to like be like that big L we were talking about. So I think we're going to come over like here and then go like over like this in this early direction. I feel like I need to make about 100 thatch foundations. Or no, probably around 40 or 50. So let's pop down here. I'm going to do that and I'm going to lay them all out. And then I'll be your bees. Just a thatch machine, and I don't thatch for nobody but you. Just a thatch machine, and I don't for nobody but you. What was that? I'm just a thatch machine, and I need thatch because I'm building a million foundations. Bow! I'm just a thatch machine. Don't work for nobody but you. Guitar lead. Worst guitar lead ever. And it was just a thatch machine. Doo doo doo. Raptor. Work for nobody but you. Oh, are we gonna fight this raptor right now? Oh, you wanna go? Get horned. Oh, baby. Why'd he take him out? That was amazing. All right. And a doom doom. Just a thatch machine. And I kill raptors with my horny horn. Ba-da-da-da. And we're back in the peaceful night. And we've built throughout the evening. And this is what we've created. It's an L thing. Let's go ahead and pop down so you guys can see. We've got a little area right here. You know, the one we had before. We've got our little ramp system that comes up to this place. This is our big kind of L-type area place thing. And what I'm thinking that we're going to do, I can't decide if we kind of want to go. I don't think we want to go the same height as what we have down there. We've built that. Oh, maybe we do. Maybe we do. Because we built this down here so we could fit the parasaur in. So we'd have to kind of count to see how big it is. If we build this the same height, we could fit the same, you know what I mean? Like, we could fit huge dinos up inside of here, too. We could bring a parasaur up here, or bring a mammoth up here, something like that. So, if we come down here and take a look, how many actual pillars is this? We put a pillar down right here. We can see. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? It's like 5, right? That's how many pillars? But it isn't really 5, is it? Or is it? Yeah, it is. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 5-ish. All right, so we got 5 pillars down there. So let's go ahead and pop up here really quickly and see how many pillars we've got up here already. I think we've got 4. So if we go like so, 1, 2, 3. Oh, that's only 3. You know what's weird that I can do over here? For some reason, and I can't figure out why this is, some of these pillars will snap like diagonally. You see that? Like that's a snap point right there. There's one over here, too. It wants to snap right there. And then it will do it right there, too. And I'm not sure what that is. I've never seen that before. It actually almost would be cool if it was uniformed. You could add a little bit of depth to your pillars, and it would be aesthetically kind of neat if it was like a uniform snap point. You could put one every like 2 pillars or something like that. You know what I'm saying? Like right there, and you could put one on the other side, like right. Oh, it won't snap to the other side. Maybe it has to do with the ramps. It might be why, because these guys don't have any. So it might be because these ramps are here or something like that. It's trying to snap to the ramp area. But yeah, so we got these guys now. What do we say? These are only 3 high. So we've got to go 4, 5 high on all of these guys. Oh my gosh, what am I getting myself into? Oh, there we go. 5 high on this guy. So I think the next stage, I'm going to go ahead and extend all the pillars, and then I'm going to start laying down the ceilings. And we're back on our ridiculously impossible platform. You could really do some funny stuff like that. You could build something. As long as there's foundations underneath, you could build something crazy up top. And I think we're going to get into one of the things I wanted to make sure you guys know is that in the as we build more, there's going to be more detail that we're going to add in. We're really just building kind of the shell of a thing right now. And we are going to add some detail in. Like, I really want to see if we can build a slip gator symbol out of walls. I think that would be really cool. But I'm not sure if it's possible yet. And previously, you know, we did some building, but we're kind of just taking baby steps. Like, this is only the second kind of big thing that we've built. And last season, we had a good building, but it was not like, you know, I don't know, super, super duper detailed. But this season, what I wanted to do is kind of go a little bit bigger, which I think is fun. And if you guys, anybody who's watched my Minecraft stuff knows for a long, long time that in Minecraft, we do big doo-doo. That's okay, it's a doo-doo. We do big builds. And so I wanted to go big, and we are definitely going big. I'm honestly not super excited about the amount of metal that this is going to be, but you can't, what can you do? You just got to play. So, and as over time, we'll get more and we'll convert the base over, and it will be rad. And then once we start to do that, once we get the shell done and we have additional metal ready to rock, I think that's when you're going to see us start to get into like some more detailed work. But for now, it is actually so nice to be able to do this. And it's really not difficult to do this stuff out of thatch and wood foundations. We can get a lot done. Look at this. I mean, we're going to get this whole ceiling done. This whole humongous ceiling. Are we going to have to make another trip? No. Nailed it. Oh, yeah, we are for the other part. So then we're going to have to come down here like so. Oh, man. Crazy. This is crazy, man. Are we going to have enough? I wonder if we'll have enough ceilings to do the whole darn thing. Can we hold 50? I just pooped right on... Oh, fine, whatever. Just pooped right on the thatch. The thatch is never... I mean, you can't wash thatch. You never get that poop out. We're really lucky that there only is just poop in this game and not, like, poop stains or anything like that. That would be the worst. Then there'd be, like, you'd have to learn, like, the water... The soap engram and the, like... Then they'd have, like, a hose... And you'd have to get like a water pump. It'd have to be powered. Powered water pump for your high pressure washer so you could wash your dinos off. Oh, that would be cool if dinos got dirty and you had to wash them off like in Farming Simulator. All right. So we've got our whole ceiling done now. We've laid it all out. Kind of trying to keep a little bit of a count of the stuff we used. I mean, that's like 100. I mean, we could do the math real quick and see what it would be. Also, let's gamma into it's the middle of the day now. Let's come back here and just take a look at it. If anything, it's large. It's large and in charge. So I did decide to, or was thinking about, leaving this part one back from the bottom there. See how the bottom is like one here? And that's just like a little lip. I thought it would be kind of cool to have a little, this is a one block, so to speak, lip that hangs out there. And we got our ramps to come up here. We've got this going on. Now, what I was wondering or thinking about, we might come off the edge on this side and make it into a T. I don't know yet. I'm not really sure. I mean, this thing is really plenty big, to be honest with you. The base does not need to be any bigger than this. This is as big as the base needs to be. Some walls around over here or something like that, maybe? Coming across. I don't know. It's hard to say, like, what it's going to evolve into, but we've definitely done something today for sure-sies. So let's take a look real quick and see how many metal stuff and things we've got. Let's pop over here just to kind of take an idea and account of how much metal we've got left as far as building supplies go. We've got 61 pillars, only 28 ceilings, and 10 ramps. So we've got a decent amount of stuff, but we really should probably just start to convert this first piece. And I think we're going to need definitely more ceilings to do that. So let's pop over here and take a look. I'm not sure how much time we got left in the video. I think we have a good amount of time. Let's pop over here and take a look. We've got tons and tons of metal. And we've got tons and tons of cementing paste. Let me see here. Well, not tons and tons of metal, but a good amount. Oh, the cementing paste is right in the same spot. I did that on purpose because it was amazing. And not tons and tons. Yeah, we got a good amount of cementing paste in there. So maybe we'll start to build some more of these metal pillars or metal ceilings, probably. I'd like to get maybe 100 of each. We'll see if we can get that done. Let's go ahead and get some fabricator stuff and things fabricating, peeps. And we're back. Fabricator stuff fabricating. Well, I think you mean smithy stuff smithying. Smithy stuff and things smithying. We got 8 more pillars here. This is, let's check this out, guys. So I think, wait, hold on. Right over here, I think on hardware, we don't have anything else. All right, so there's no more metal over here. There's no more metal on tonnage, right? And inside of here, we've got about, what is this, like 12. Now we still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 600 smithy paste and 28. But down over here now, we have got how much metal? I kept a little bit, 100. Couple hundred cementing paste, use all the rest. Oh, wait, we have some more up there. Okay, so we still have a little bit more cementing paste, but we're really close to out of metal. But then over in this area, I have moved some of our building supplies. And now you can see. Oh, yeah, baby. Nailed it, ace to KB stopped. 105 metal pillars and 102 metal ceilings. I'm actually going to go ahead. I know we're probably going to need more than 100 metal ceilings. Oh, I know that we're going to have more than 100 metal ceilings. I'm going to end up counting out the foundations so I can know exactly how many of those we're going to need as well before we start getting that converted over. And I think I'd like to do like a big montage episode where we convert maybe this whole entire structure that's not metal yet, and we convert it all over to metal. I think that would be really cool. But at the beginning of the episode today, if you remember, not so long ago, we were up on the mountain and we were getting some stuff and things going, right? And I think, was that a thing? A bad guy? Was there a bad guy? No, it was the tail of a Dodecarus. So I think now it's time to head back over and reap the rewards. I'm hoping all the stuff over there is done forging. So let's go ahead and grab our guys. Let's get tonnage. Let's get Pugly. And let's head up to the mountain forge and bring back all of our metal. Come on, guys. Let's do it. Slowly. And we're back. Look at Pugly coming for a landing, man. This is so cool. Oh, man. Are you not going to be high enough for me? Can I get on you from your wing? Crap. All right. Come over here, Pugly. I want to hang out with you for a minute. Yeah, you're looking the right direction. Come on over, buddy. You know you want to. You're thinking about it. You really want to. I'm going to jump again because that's how you get people to come to you. There we go. All right. Get on him. Now, can you still fly with me on you? Oh, crap, you can't. I put his burden. I did the math really quickly. If you guys don't know, and this has always been a little bit strange to me, but the way burden works is, I do believe it's, you start to see an increase in slowness on the animal when they reach over 85% burden. So with the 1600, what's 85% of 1600? The math carries 1360? Yeah, 1360. So like around 1360-ish. Maybe a little bit more because he has 1682 health. He would start to increase to see a slowness. So we can carry 1300 weight on this guy, 1350 weight probably before he gets slow. So 1300 metal. That's crazy, man. 1300 metal on this guy before we'd even slow him down. And he's only like a level 30 or 20 something when we got him. And he's only at level 60 now, so we can still like get more levels on him and pump his weight even more. And as a weight machine, I mean, a carry machine, like that's crazy. Do we have to carry 1,300 ingots? Like if I could get him to carry 2,000 at once, oh my God, guys, that would be so crazy cool. So now we drop 200 off of him. I think we should be able to, I'm thirsty. I think we should be able to get him to fly now. And we can fly him right into the base area, I think. There's too many people here. Land! Let me off then. Why can't you let me off? There we go. There was this little bit of lag happening there. Can I get into your inventory? Oh, come on. Oh, come on. Oh, you land, homie. All right, this is better. This works perfectly. So then we can just offload. And we're back up to a couple thousand metal or something like that. I think what we say when we're up there, we got 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, like 1,800 or 21. No, 2,100. That's right. So we're back up to 2,100 metal already. So we're doing stuff and things. It's like the metal game. I'll tell you what, this is like the currency of Ark. Would be either metal or probably, what do you think, stone? But we got a ton of it. And we're kicking butt, guys. So I think, like I said, I don't know. I want to go out in the next couple of episodes. I'm thinking that We got to do a little bit of taming. I hate to try to do episodes where I'm like, today we're going to do this and we're going to tame this, because it's really hard to do that. But I do really want to start focusing on some perfect tames. And I feel like I want redemption for the RG. I'd love to get a couple of high level RGs, and we have the kibble to do it, guys. We've got a bunch. You know, one of the things I got to do is TFC, who is a Hermitcraft member who's come over to help us out. I don't know if I showed you guys this. He dropped off a ton of kibble for us. So we have 29 Stego kibble now, enough to tame at least a couple RGs. So if you find a couple 120s, it would be great. And when they, right now, RG breeding is not a thing. I think we're going to see in the next update, there's going to be mammal breeding. So I know that that probably means mammoths, maybe wolves. I'm not sure what else is going to be in there. Maybe Paraceratherium and all those guys too. But yeah, today we got some building done, and I think it was really cool. And I had a fun time hanging out with you. A little bit different, a little bit slower paced stuff and things today. And we got to hang out and chit chat a little bit more, which I really like. And I hope that you guys did too. Stop trying to eat me, man. So if you guys liked the video, please don't forget to show your support and hit the like button. Feel free to share it.